Hello everyone. Today we are going to speak about tensile structures and 3D truss systems in Revit. This video will cover as a tutorial how we can create tensile structures and 3D truss systems because they are somewhat connected to each other. Please comment below if you are having any difficulties with Revit structure systems and if you have, what they are. And don't forget to give a like if this video and such videos adds you value because it really supports the channel. Let's hop into the video. You'll be learning within a couple of minutes how to create such tensile structures and in different shapes. We have here a straight shape, a sphere, a double curvature, and ellipsoid or spheroid, depending on how you would like to call it. So we will be going step-by-step process and everything will be covered within the next 5 minutes. So stay tuned and keep watching. This is a family that we need to create in order to get a pattern shape surface. In order to do that, we go File, New, and then we go to Family. And once we go to the Family, we select the conceptual mass family from here, and then metric mass. And you will be jumped right into this family. Then you do modeling, some modeling shapes, depending on what kind of surface you want, what kind of structure you want. And in this case, let's say I would like to get an ellipsoid and I want to select, I do two curvatures and I select both of them and then I just click create form. In this case, it will allow me to select which form I want. And then the next thing I have to do is I need to divide the surface. So if I select a surface and click on the divide the surface and I select the fixed distance rather than a fixed number and I select 1 meter, you can also use imperial measures, but in this case I will be using metric, and the surface will be divided in a pattern of 1 meters. So now the next thing, we need to run a family that is pattern based generic model. So in order to do that, we go again family, new, and we try to find the metric generic model pattern based. Once we find it, we open it up and you will see a family that looks like this. You might be worried that this looks a little bit different than the other family types. Don't worry, I'm making a fast track so you can see step-by-step process what I'm doing. And right after that, I will be explaining you why I did those steps. So let's start with that. The first thing that I would like to start with is to create reference points, and I would like to explain you why I'm creating those. Because when you change the shape, let's say 1 meter to 1 meter, 2 meter to 2 meter, the structure changes, the grid structure changes as well. So we would like to make sure that everything, all the references are constrained and working together. Therefore, what we need to do is we need to create a point elements and all of those point elements to be placed on a particular reference plane, which is at each point. So if I go here and select the reference point and place a point, and select the reference point, place the other point, and repeat this for the rest. Now we can select all the 4 points that we just created. We can even create a parametric offset for the height. So right now I will be putting it as a height. And then I will be stating this as 500. The good thing over here is that if I change the grid size to 1 meter to 1 meter, it will follow the grid. And I will be following the next steps in a fast track. So now what we are going to do is we are going to do a quick testing. If I push this one down, I would like to see if everything follows up or not. In this case, you can see that the shape is not following up my behavior. And if I do push this one down, I can see that this is not following up as well. So what we are going to do is now we are going to do a different format. So we are going to delete this and we are going to actually go and create. Once we are ready with the bottom shape, we need to check if everything is working. So right now, if I push, it curves and bends down. And if I push the sides, everything moves smoothly the way I want. So we want to make sure that the behavior is the same at all times. And from time to time, we need to check in order to make sure that everything is fine. So let's continue the fast track. Now we are going to create a parametric material, so top finish, I would call, in order to change this glass or opaque or any other material I want. In this case, I will just go ahead with the gloss. Once you're ready, we will need to upload it into the family one. And right now we already have family five, so which is this family. It's already uploaded. And what we do is we will just select the pattern and we will need to apply in family five, which is going to load in a second. And you will be able to see how it comes up. So all in all, you can go ahead and do different type of structures. You can go ahead doing double curvature, go ahead a single curvature, go ahead a straight surface and so forth. If you like this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up and share it with your professional network so more people can benefit out of this content. And don't forget to comment if you have any questions or if you have any suggestions for future tutorials or any other issues that you are facing with right now. So just go ahead and comment below.